morning students, welcome back to the YouTube channel of Venus Public School. We will be continuing with chapter 11, force and pressure of class 8. Yesterday we have discussed pressure in fluids, and when we are talking about fluids, we are talking about liquids and gases. Yesterday we have seen basically the pressure in liquids, where we have discussed two major points. Number one, at every point inside a liquid, the molecule of that liquid or any substance at that particular point used to experience or exerts equal amount of pressure in all the directions in same magnitude. Clear? Number one. Number two, we have discussed that pressure increases with depth. Clear? Pressure increases with depth. Yesterday I told you to perform two simple experiments at home to identify all these two points which we have discussed yesterday, which are telling us all about the liquids and pressure. Or we need to keep these two things in our mind every time when we are talking about pressure and liquids. Okay, I have told you to take a bottle. In that bottle you have to, in first experiment, what you will have to do, you will have to put holes at a same height but at different points. Clear? At same height, all points should be at same height, but at different corners or different points all around the circle. Clear? And when you will fill water in it, you will observe that all the lengths, where the lengths from the bottle are equal in all the directions. Okay, which represents that at a particular length, at a particular height, or at a particular level, the direction and the magnitude of the pressure is always equal. Okay, that's why they are falling at the equal length from the bottle. Okay, and in the next experiment I told you to make holes at different heights. Okay, and then fill water in that bottle, and you will observe that the water fall at different lengths. Okay, this represents, and the hole which is at the bottom is throwing the water at a very high pressure, so it will reaches to the maximum length, which represents the that pressure increases with depth. Clear? Now today we are going to discuss atmospheric pressure. When we are talking about atmospheric pressure, we are talking about gaseous pressure. Clear? Because what is atmosphere? Atmosphere is basically a combination of gases all around us. Clear? That means our atmosphere. Our atmosphere is having gases, water vapors, dust particles, very minute dust particles, etc. But though the size of these particles of gases, dust, vapors, etc. are very, very minute, that's why we are able to see through them. Clear? Even in the presence of the dust particles, even in the presence of water vapors, even in the presence of molecules of gases, we are able to see through, we are able to see to the infinite length. How you'll be able to come to know that we are able to see through the infinite through the atmosphere to the infinite length? In the night, you are able to see the stars, which are many light years away from you. That represents that you are able to see to the infinite length. Clear? So, and we are seeing those stars through our atmosphere. So basically, the size of the particles of all the constituents of atmosphere are very, very minute. But still they are there, and they are particles, they are molecules. And yesterday we have discussed, in fluids, each and every molecule used to exert pressure on the other. Clear? And the pressure increases with depth. We have discussed it yesterday. So basically, if this is planet Earth, and if this is the atmosphere, then while we are going deep down into the atmosphere, that means here at the last layer where we are situated, we must feel a huge or enormous amount of pressure. Okay, and while we are going up, pressure must be decreases. Okay, so yes, both the things are true. Like at the bottom, at the earth crust, we are experiencing huge amount of pressure. But have you ever think that if we are experiencing that huge amount of pressure on us, then why we have not got crushed till now? Okay, yes, the reason behind not crushing by the atmospheric pressure is that, or the pressure exerted by the atmosphere, by the gas gaseous atmosphere on us is that the pressure exerted by our body is equal to the pressure exerted by the atmosphere. So basically our body is exerting the same amount of pressure to the atmosphere same as the atmosphere is exerting on our body. Clear? Now so have you ever observed. So basically what is, so let us first discuss the definition, then we will discuss few more examples to understand what is atmospheric pressure, and you might have experienced it. Clear? So basically atmospheric pressure, what is atmospheric pressure? Atmospheric pressure is the force, is the pressure exerted due to the force equal to the mass of 1 kg on every square centimeter. Suppose this is any object. Clear? Suppose this is any object, and when this object is divided into like sections of 1 centimeter square, okay, like length and breadth of this small block is 1 by 1, okay. So this is a square of 1 by 1 centimeter, or 1 centimeter square is the area, okay. And each 1 centimeter square of the area is experiencing 1 kg of force. Force is mass into gravity. So 1 kg of force it is experiencing. Clear? So suppose this is having the area of like 100 square centimeter. So 100 kg of mass, 100 kg of force it will be experiencing, okay. And thus the total force, or the total force experienced by that particular object, clear, due to the atmosphere gases, due to the atmosphere around this object, is called atmospheric pressure. Clear? Is called atmospheric pressure. Clear? So let us take another example. Suppose if this is a human being, and you are dividing this human being into the blocks of 1 centimeter square, then you will observe that the total amount of force which is exerted by the atmospheric gases on this human is equal to, like, every centimeter square of that particular human being is experiencing 1 kg of force over it, and which makes a very huge amount of atmospheric pressure on that particular human being. So basically this is what atmospheric pressure is, and this is exerted due to the atmospheric gases, or the fluid, or the molecules of the gases which are present all around us. Okay, now to understand this we can perform some an activity through which you will be able to understand. So to do that, what we have to do is to understand what is atmospheric pressure, what we can do is we can perform a simple activity. Clear? In this activity, what we need to do is we need to take a plastic bottle, add some boiling water in it. Okay, take a plastic bottle, add some boiling water in it. Clear? When you are add some boiling water in it, and the steam comes out of the water, will expel most of the air from the bottle. Okay, when the steam coming out from the bottle, what will happen? It will expel, it will push all the air present in the bottle in the from the neck, and the most of the air filled in the bottle comes out. Clear? Now after about 1 or 2 minutes, close the cap tightly. Now after when the all the air from the bottle move out from the bottle with the steam, then close the bottle cap. Okay, and then pour the cold water over the bottle. Okay, and then pour the cold water over the bottle. What you will observe, the bottle got crushed in it. Okay, the bottle got crushed in it. It got crushed, its shape is completely changed. Okay, and this is what, why it is happening, because all the air which were present in the bottle moved out, and while you are pouring that cold water in it, what will happen? Now the atmosphere used to exert pressure, the atmospheric gases present around it used to exert pressure on it, and there is no substance which is there inside the bottle which used to oppose this pressure, which atmospheric pressure. So this represents the presence of atmospheric pressure. Okay, so basically why we are not collapsed, why we are not crushed due to that pressure, because we are opposing that pressure from inside the body. Okay, but now this is what we have talked about at the crust. Now you might have observed while you are going up in the sky, like if you might have seen the videos or the movies of astronomers, what they used to wear, they used to wear special suits, space suits, suits. In those space suits, two arrangements are there. Number one, oxygen. Oxygen. The presence of oxygen is there because to breathe, to survive, we need oxygen. Okay. So oxygen tanks are fitted at the back, and they used to provide oxygen. Clear in those space suits. Number two, they used to maintain the pressure, atmospheric pressure inside the suits. Okay. Clear? Because why they are doing so? Because while you are moving up from the crust towards the outer space, or to move away, upward, where the density of the gases, where the density of the gases are less. As the density of the gases are less, the pressure is also less. And I hope all of you are aware of what is density. Density is number of molecules present per unit volume. Number of molecules present per unit volume. Okay. Suppose these are two same blocks having different densities. So number of molecules present in the same volume is greater in this case as compared to this case. So this must be having less low density, and this must be having high density. So basically we know that at near the crust, what is happening, there is most the carbon particles, the pollutants, particles from the pollutants, water vapors, dust particles. Okay, so the lower layer of the atmosphere are quite denser than that of the uppermost layers. Clear? So while you are moving up in the sky, what will happen, the pressure gradually decreases. When you are going towards the higher altitudes, you might have observed that if you have gone to some hill stations, you feel difficult to breathe, and you will observe like dizziness. Okay, so this is unconsciousness sometimes. So why it is happening? Because the pressure inside the body is like constant. It is not going to vary very quickly, whereas while you are going up, what will happen, the change in the atmospheric pressure is drastic. So the body is not able to accommodate or change that drastic change in the atmospheric pressure. That's why the blood pressure inside the body, or the fluids which are filled inside the body, they used to exert more pressure to the outer atmosphere. So thus you will feel unwell. Clear? And if you will go in the sky or space without wearing any those special space suits, what will happen, your blood vessels will get burst due to the pressure of fluids which are filled inside the body. Okay, because in the outer space there is no atmosphere at all. So there is no atmosphere from the outer from the outer side of the body. Thus the pressure which is equal to the atmospheric pressure inside the body will move towards the lower pressure, will released towards the lower pressure, and as a result your veins, your body will get burst in the atmospheric pressure without those special space suits. Okay, these rubber suckers, vacuum pads, rubber suckers you might have is one of the example, rubber suckers. Clear? So while you push that rubber sucker, it will release all the gas from here, and when you will release it, what will happen, due to the atmospheric pressure on this rubber pad, what will happen, it gets stuck to any substance, to any plane surface or object. Okay, so these rubber suckers are the example of a very common example of atmospheric pressure. Okay, we have already discussed what are the effects of atmospheric pressure at the higher altitudes. At the higher altitudes, because the blood pressure is, or the pressure inside the body is greater than that of the atmospheric pressure, because at higher altitudes the density is low, or the density of air is low, or the atmosphere is low, so
it could what will happen? It could ear diseases, okay, cause imbalance between the pressure, because of the imbalance between the pressure of inside and outside the body. Clear? And we have also discussed about the space suits. Clear? Which is specially designed to bear that pressure for the astronauts. Clear? Or so that is it from this chapter. We are done with this chapter, and we'll be continuing with the next chapter in the next video. Thank you so much.